Hey guys, Kevin with On Point Pro Styles in Gainesville, Georgia. We had a delivery. We got our plotter from plotterdepot.com. So I'm wanting to do a video of, let's get it unboxed and let's get it put together. So let's get to it. Okay, so we're basically just gonna unbox it. We're gonna look at all the parts that's inside the box, see what tools we'll need to put the stand together and get it all put together. So. plotterdepot.com, guys, check them out. All right, first up, got a box of some stuff in here. This is really well packaged. So there's our plotter, that's cool. Workhorse. Okay, so the plotter box is a box within a box. This is gonna be our stand parts. Beautiful. All the parts for our stands. So I'm gonna get all this unwrapped, get the plastic off, figure out what tools we need, and we'll get to putting it together and setting it up. Okay, so I've taken all the wrapping and the shipping materials off of all of our parts so I can identify all the parts. This is going to be your hardware box that's inside. It has all your bolts and nuts and washers, and then comes with the tools, which is pretty convenient. This is your catch basket. I'm just going to set this to the side. That's the last piece that you'll install. Inside this box is going to be your power cable, USB, your blade holder, which we'll do a video on that, your blades. So that's going to be last as well. So I'm going to set that aside. And we'll get started with putting it together. So the first thing we're gonna need is the feet and the legs, which are these pieces here. So we'll start with those and start putting those together. Okay, so when putting this together, there's a couple things to look for. I'm putting this together, basically visualizing the machine is facing me. So we'll be talking about the front of the machine and the back of the machine. So there is a left and a right side. So how to identify those? You have your legs. The plate side is actually the top of the leg. That's what the machine is actually going to mount to later. The bottom is obviously your leg portion. So you've got two holes here. Those go to the rear of the machine. So standing the leg upright, this finished side goes to the outside, and then the two holes that you saw here go to the rear of the machine, which is now closest to the camera, and then the other side, same thing, plate stays to the top. You've got your two holes here that go to the rear of the machine, so this facing the machine, this would be my right leg, this would be my left. So one last thing before we start putting it together is your legs have holes that are not dead center of the leg. So they're longer side and a shorter side. So the longer side goes to the rear of the machine to support the weight of the media rollers on the back of the machine. So this being our left leg, this is gonna mount to the bottom. As far as the hardware, it's pretty simple. I just dumped all mine in this box. So everything's gonna use the same. It's gonna be a bolt, a washer, and a nut. You're gonna put your washer on your bolt before you insert it. You insert the bolt with the washer through the hole, and spin the nut on. These you can go ahead and tighten down now. Now, as far as putting the bolts in through the top or putting the bolts in through the bottom, doesn't matter, just make sure they're tight when you're done. This is our left leg we just completed. This is going to be our right leg. So this is on the right side, two holes to the back, longer portion of the leg to the rear. So bolt, washer, and nuts. We've got them assembled. So we've got our right side and our left side. So Next, we'll work on the cross brace. Okay, so this next part's a little bit trickier if you're by yourself and you don't have a second set of hands to help you out. There's multiple pieces that need to all be bolted up at the same time. So you've got your legs with the feet installed. You've got two of these. There's a left and a right side. And what you're looking for, the notches to go down and the bracket. So these are your roller brackets. So they mount to the outside of the leg and the notches go to the bottom. And you'll notice, you remember the two holes here? Well, there's also two holes on the inside edge here. So this is going to wrap around the outside. Your brace is going to mount to the inside like that on all the same holes. And then you're going to have one of these, which again, there's a longer side and a shorter side. And there's an inside and an outside. So they mount with the L on the outside of the leg where the holes are, longer, shorter. Longer side goes to the front of the machine. So this would be our right side. This would be our left side. And this mounts to the two top holes. So this would be the last piece on. So like I said, it's gonna look kind of crazy. It's a lot to going on here. You got your cross brace, you got your outside piece here, and then you've got that piece to go in the top two holes. So my suggestion would be start with these two pieces here and do the bottom bolt. Bolt in the washer. I'm gonna go ahead and drop that. Whoops, I'm gonna drop that in on the top hole. Or I'm sorry, the bottom hole. We need to leave the top loop or open. I'm gonna drop that in on the bottom hole. We're gonna raise it up. And I'm just gonna use this as kind of a kickstand. We've got the bottom one installed. We're gonna have a bolt and a washer. And now I'm gonna do the top inside bolt. I'm gonna go ahead and lock these in place. There we go. All right, so we're left loose a little bit there. Now we've got our piece here, L brake, L to the inside of the machine, and long side to us. So this is the wrong side. Okay. Long side to us, L to the inside of the machine, mounts on the two top holes. So we'll go ahead and do that now. Same thing, bolt the washer. There we go. Got it to play nice. And then you've got your bottom hole on the inside. All right, I'm gonna leave those loose and go ahead and put together this other side. Get this set in here. Doing the inside top, do the bottom inside. Now we'll do this piece, L on the inside, longer toward the front. All right, good deal. Now that we've got all that on there, let's tighten it up. Okay, you guys, now that we've got all that tightened up, you're gonna notice you've got another center support. This one, you're not gonna use all the holes. This one goes on the front side of the legs, and you'll notice you have two holes diagonal from each other. You've got one on the outside, and then you've got one that goes this way, a lower. You've got an upper and a lower. It's just for twisting support, so it doesn't need to be, you know, four bolted like the back one. Pop it into place. And then, like I said, you're gonna put two bolts on this side, one on the top, one on the bottom, one on the bottom, one on the top. actually going to lay this back for easier access to those bottom bolts. All right, all tight. You're going to have some nuts and bolts and washers left over. Seems like they just, there's a lot to put in these things, so they don't count them out one by one. So you got a couple extra, keep them, hang on to them. So next step is we're going to mount the machine to its top plates. Okay, so on the bottom, you're going to notice that there's tabletop legs, which is pretty neat, but we're going to unscrew those. And remember, the long part of the arms is the front of the machine. On this back left leg, you'll notice you have a green and yellow wire. That's your grounding wire, which will hook up in case there's static or something on the film that you're cutting or whatever the media is, that helps ground the machine down. So I've got all four of those off. I'm going to set these aside and we're going to line those holes up. Set our machine right in it. Then take all four legs and put them right back on. The next thing we want to do is we want to make sure we ground this machine down. I've seen people not put these on there. If you're using this for window tint, which I'm assuming you are, a lot of window tint has static built up in it. So this is just a precautionary measure so that if you build up static with your tint or through your body, you touch the machine, that it doesn't short it out. So the best place for this wire, given its length, is going to be the top bolt that goes through facing in this way. So we're just gonna loosen the nut up on the inside of the machine and we're gonna slide the fork down between the frame and the nut. And we're going to tighten that down and that'll ground that machine down. So. And there we go. We got the ground attached, ready to go. All right, we're coming to the end here. So we're going to take our media rollers and these have notches on them, squared off notches. So. Slide those into place. There we go. And then last, it's gonna be the media basket. Okay, so you're gonna obviously, there's really no front or back to this thing, but you do have one that's, one side's gonna go to the front, so it goes under the legs, sets into these notches, just like that. And into the front notches. Okay, so there it is, our plotter cutter all put together, mounted, everything's tight, media basket, rollers. This thing's ready to put to work. Again, this is the 28-inch Workhorse from plotterdepot.com. So definitely check them out, software and plotters. Pretty neat. So hope that helps you put one together, helps you get through the process. Not very difficult, does help to have a second set of hands, but definitely doable without them. So thanks for watching.